Luke Skywalker is about to undertake a journey to a distant solar system, and a journey of the spirit as well. No matter that an empire is against him, he is moved by vengeance, but he is moved too by the image of a young woman in terrible danger.
Luke!
Huh?
You've let us drift off course again.
What?
Mos Eisley spaceport is that way, over that ridge.
Oh, yeah, right.
That's the third time you've strayed, Luke. If you're tired, I could take over the controls or C-3PO.
No. It's just... I can't get it out of my mind, Ben. What they did to my aunt and uncle. I keep seeing it over and over.
I understand, Luke.
But I'm all right, really. How are you two doing back there? Hanging on, 3PO?
Oh, yes, sir.
How's R2?
He says he's very well, thank you, sir.
Luke, pull up there by the summit of the ridge. I want to take a moment's pause before we push on to Mos Eisley. Now we'll have a good view from up here. Ah, there it is, Luke. Mos Eisley spaceport.
Well, looks rather shoddy and disreputable for a spaceport, if you don't mind me saying so, sir.
You will never find a more wretched hive of scum and villainy in the whole galaxy. Come, Luke. We'll take a closer look.
Ben!
Hmm?
I'll be all right. I promise. I won't let you down.
No, I believe you won't, Luke. If you knew something of the Force, its mental disciplines would be of great help to you now. But we shall have to wait until after we've left this planet to begin your training. For now, you must give your full attention to our mission. Our chances of success are small enough as it is. When we've reached our destination, there will be time to let your feelings come forth.
You're sure we can find passage to Alderaan down there?
Nothing is sure, Luke. But our best chance of doing it, and doing it without attracting attention, lies down there in Mos Eisley. Tramp freight haulers, smugglers, and pirates of all types pass through there constantly.
Oh, I've heard some wild stories about it.
There are a few questions asked down there, and most of those can be answered simply enough with cash. Now, people mind their own business. It enhances their life expectancy. Now, we should find just the sort of tough mercenary characters we need.
You sound as if you've done this kind of thing before.
When I was a Jedi Knight, and thereafter, I became familiar with a good many unusual people and places, my young friend.
What are we going to do about the droids? They could attract a lot of attention.
We shall have to deal with that problem as it arises. We certainly can't risk leaving them behind. R2 is far too important, and 3PO already knows too much for us to chance his falling into the hands of the Empire.
Ben, that girl in the message R2 brought you, she said that she was... What?
If we were at the High Court of Alderaan, you'd be expected to refer to her as Your Highness, or the Princess Leia Organa. But I fancy that, under the circumstances, she wouldn't mind if you referred to her with more brevity.
Okay. Princess, then. She said that the information stored in R2's memory banks was vital to the Rebellion. What do you think it is?
I don't know. But I trust her not to exaggerate. We must believe her message absolutely and proceed on the assumption that the fate of the Rebel Alliance rests with us and with R2.
And she said her ship was under attack. Do you think she's all right?
She is alive, almost certainly, but I don't doubt her circumstances are difficult. Imperial Inquisitors have some ugly ways of obtaining information from prisoners. She will have the means to resist for some while, but not indefinitely. It's one more reason for us to make haste to Alderaan. Come, we have business to attend to. To Mos Eisley.
Mos Eisley's crawling with Imperial stormtroopers, Ben. You almost never see him on Tatooine.
Yes, there are more than I had foreseen.
Maybe we should try another way off-world.
No, our best hope still lies here. There seems to be a checkpoint up ahead. Take this side street.
Well, I guess it's like you said. The Empire's not stopping at anything to find 3PO and R2.
The stormtroopers are not the opposition I fear most. The Emperor has other, more fearsome servants at his command.
Darth Vader? The one who killed my father? He's the one...
I believe that's another Imperial checkpoint, Luke. There seems to be no getting around
them. I could turn around, make a run for it.
And seal off the exit routes. Besides, that would put us right back where we started.
Uh-oh, that stormtrooper ahead is signaling for me to stop.
Best to brazen it out. Do as he says and follow my cues. Answer any questions they ask, but otherwise let me do the talking.
Fine with me. R2, 3PO, don't say a word.
Yes, sir.
You there, driver? Yes? How long have you had these two droids?
About 3 or 4 seasons.
They're there for sale if you want them.
I've got no use for them. We're looking for 2 stolen ones. You, let me see your identification and the ownership for these droids.
But I was...
You don't need to see his identification.
We don't need to see his identification.
These aren't the droids you're looking for.
These aren't the droids we're looking for.
You can go on about his business.
You can go on about your business.
Move along, Luke.
Move along, move along.
Oh, yeah. Sure thing. Are they looking at us?
No, they've stopped a robo-hauler. I dare say they've forgotten us already, Luke.
Nobody's following us?
All the stormtroopers back there at the checkpoint seem otherwise occupied to me.
Ben, how did we get past them? I thought we were dead for sure.
You know, the Force can have a strong influence on the weak-minded. You will find it a powerful ally.
But how in the...
Turn off here and go to the end of that side street. There's a cantina there. That's where we'll find what we're looking for.
So many non-humans in one place. Look, there's a Mirian hammerhead over there. A Stofo lupinoid. And look, a couple of Tintin dwarves.
Artu, look.
Even the humans don't look human.
This cantina is a meeting ground and a place of business for half the shady goings-on in this part of space. Now stay close to me. Artu and 3PO, you two.
Oh, yes, sir.
Hey, you.
Huh?
We don't serve that kind in here.
What?
Your droids. You'll have to stay outside. We don't want them in here.
Well, Ben...
Best to do as he says. We don't want to attract attention.
You think we should risk leaving them alone?
Now, there shouldn't be any problem so long as 3PO and R2 stay with the land speeder. If anything goes wrong, they can summon us from the doorway.
Should I stay with them?
No. It's best to have someone to guard one's back in this kind of place.
Whatever you say. Listen, 3PO, why don't you and R2 wait outside by my speeder? We don't want any trouble.
I heartily agree with you, sir.
You heard what Ben said?
Yes, sir. If there's any problem, we'll signal you from the doorway. Back we go, R2.
3PO?
Yes, Master Luke?
I'll bring you something.
Oh, thank you.
Here, let's step up to the bar.
Excuse me.
That spaceman standing there strikes me as a likely fellow with whom to make our preliminary inquiries. Order something for yourself, Luke. This may take some time.
Okay.
Excuse me, my friend.
Huh?
But I wonder if I might have a word with you. You're a Corellian spacer, are you not?
What about it?
I'm in the market to charter a fast starship, and I've been told by those in the know that the Corellian vessels are among the very best.
You heard right. Except that Corellians aren't among. We are the best.
Ah, splendid. And would you by any chance know of a starship that's available for hire?
If you'd have come in here yesterday, you could have had mine. But I'm committed to a charter. I raise ship tonight.
A pity. Perhaps you could recommend someone else.
Well, there aren't too many Corellians in port right now. And anybody else would be just a second rater. Let's see now. Oh, yeah, there's the Falcon.
Falcon?
The Millennium Falcon. Han Solo's ship?
And would this Han Solo be available at present for a job?
I'd be surprised if he wasn't. Han ain't been doing so well lately. He was around here a little while ago. In fact, there's his first mate standing over there. Mm-hmm. The giant shaggy one.
A Wookiee.
That's right, but a damn good first mate and co-pilot all the same.
Hey, Chewbacca, come here. I got somebody for you to meet.
Here's your drink, Ben.
Oh, thank you, Luke.
What do you say, Chewbacca? This fellow here's looking for a ship.
No, just one quick trip.
You understand the Wookiee language?
Some, yes. Thank you, friend. You've been of great assistance to me.
Yeah, sure, old-timer. Glad to oblige.
Guess I'll be shoving off.
Clear skies to you, Chewbacca.
The Millennium Falcon. Is that the name of your ship? I was told she's fast. No, that will be more than satisfactory. I'm not looking for anything elaborate, Chewbacca. Just quick passage to Alderaan.
He doesn't like you, boy. I don't either. You just watch yourself.
Sorry.
Chewbacca, is your Captain Solo available to discuss terms of hiring?
Wanted men, sonny. I've got the death sentence on me in 12 solar systems.
Oh, I'll be careful.
Pardon me a moment, Chewbacca.
You'll be dead.
Just a moment, please, my friend. This little one here isn't worth the effort. Come, let me buy you and your companion there something to drink.
Stay out of this, Grandpa. I'll fix you when I finish with this little fool. Now for you, you old bastard!
That old man, he just about sliced your boy in half.
And he lops Hockey's arm clean off.
Luke, are you hurt?
Here, let me help you up. Yes.
Hey, you, the man, who told you could take a break? Get back to work. Show's over, everybody.
Are you all right, Luke?
I knocked my head on something, but I'll be okay.
Hey, some of you get those bodies out of here. Go on, or you'll never get another free drink from me.
Ben, I've never seen anything like that in my life. Your lightsaber
was... It's a last resort, Luke. Never forget that. Now, this is Chewbacca. He is...
A Wookiee? I've never seen a real live Wookiee before.
Yes, quite. But he's also first mate and co-pilot on a ship that might suit our needs. His captain is nearby somewhere. Chewbacca will bring him to speak to us.
Gosh, Ben, he's enormous.
Yes. Now we must find a booth somewhere out of the way where we can wait. Ah, come, Luke.
Artu, do you see that large reptilian creature tethered over there, the one wearing the saddle? I believe that is what they call a dewback, the creature Master Luke was telling me about. What? Imperial stormtroopers, where? Oh, look here. To be taking up positions to search the area. Come along, Artu. We have to go and attract Master Luke's attention from the cantina doorway.
Watch it, Joy. Who do you think you're shoving?
I do beg your pardon, sir, but I wasn't shoving you.
And I say you were.
Go on, beat it before we take a wrench to your boat.
That won't be necessary, sir. Come along, Artu.
Damn droids.
Look like the stormtroopers are forming up for a house-to-house search. Our only recourse is to hide. What do you mean, what if we can't? How should I know? I'm not programmed for deception and suspect behavior like some that I could mention. You're the one that got us into all this. Why don't you think of something? Oh, look, more stormtroopers. We're trapped. What should we do? What do you mean I'm supposed to be the intelligent one? Wait. That used droid lot over there, come on. When we get there, Artu, stand at the end of the display line with me. Keep perfectly still. Don't make a sound.
Sir, there's a droid lot here. Where is the owner? Hey, you!
Huh?
Come here.
Well, soldier, what can I do for you?
You bought or sold any droids in the last few days?
Nah, business has been off. Last stock I moved was 10 days ago. I haven't purchased any in even longer. You want to see my sales records?
Not necessary. There will be a verification team by later. Come on, and make sure you try every door you pass. If any are open, take a quick check inside.
I wonder what that was all about. Hey, what's this? What are you two doing standing there?
Well,
Our master instructed us to wait here, sir. He's canvassing the area to see if anyone wants any household maintenance jobs done.
Well, don't stand right here on my lot, you half-wit. People will think you belong to me.
Oh.
I got enough trouble selling these old clunkers without you hanging around confusing things. Now move!
Moving, sir. Come along, R2.
Sheesh. Darn pesky droids. There's not one of them has the brains of a womp rat.
Boy, this guy's sure taking his time, Ben.
I think this is him now.
Hello, gents. Han Solo, captain of the Millennium Falcon.
I'm pleased to meet you, Captain Solo.
My first mate, Chewbacca, here tells me you're looking for passage to the Alderaan system. Is that right?
That is a fact, we are. If yours is a fast ship.
Fast ship? You mean to tell me you've never heard of the Millennium Falcon?
Should I have?
Where you been? The Falcon's the ship that made the Kessel Run in less than 12 parsecs.
Which would make you a spice smuggler, is that correct?
Well, why don't we just say that I'm an independent businessman. Very independent.
In the best Corellian tradition?
Yeah, I've been known to bend the law too on occasion. I've outrun Imperial warships. Not the local bulk cruisers, mind you, but the big ships in the line. The Falcon's fast enough for you, old man.
I believe we understand one another, you and I.
What's the cargo?
Only passengers. Myself, the boy here, two droids, and no questions asked.
What is it you're running from? Some sort of local trouble?
Let's just say that we'd prefer to avoid any Imperial entanglements.
Well, that's the trick, isn't it? And it's going to cost you something extra. 10,000.
What?
In advance.
10,000? We could almost buy our own ship for that.
Yeah, but who's going to fly it for you, kid? You?
You bet I could. I'm not such a bad pilot, Mike. Come on, then. We don't have to sit here
easy,
and listen.
Easy, Luke. Captain Solo, we haven't that much cash with us, but we could pay you 2,000 now plus 15 more when we get to Alderaan.
17, huh? Okay. You guys have got yourself a starship.
Good.
Oh, just a friendly word of advice. I better get the rest of my money when we hit Alderaan. Me and my partner don't like it when somebody tries to cheat on a deal.
You needn't worry. We'll keep our end of the deal if you live up to yours.
I'd call that a real wise attitude, old man. We'll leave as soon as you're ready. Docking bay 94.
94. We'll meet you there with the money shortly. Oh,
good. Hey, I saw what was left of a couple of small-time punks being carted out the front door a while ago. Your handiwork?
I had no choice. They forced the fight.
Well, no loss to society, but it looks like those stormtroopers over there noticed the remains.
Dan?
Wait, Luke.
They're headed this way. I suggest the back door, gents. Right over there.
Thank you, Captain Solo.
Pleasure's mine.
We'll meet you at the docking bay. Come, Luke.
Right.
You seen anything of an old man and a boy?
Oh, no. Chewie? No. But then it's not our job to watch people, is it?
Bartender, I thought you said they came over here.
I said I thought they did. Look, I got other things to do besides keep an eye on every single customer.
All right, then we'll check out the back door. Follow me.
Yeah, those two guys must really be desperate. 17,000. This could really save my neck, Chewie. I wonder who they are. You say he dropped those two with a lightsaber? Who uses one of those antiques anymore? Me either. Still, we gotta play the hand the way it's dealt. Jabba the Hutt's getting a little anxious to be paid off. You go collect our gear. I got a couple of things to do. I'll meet you back at the Falcon. We'll get ready to raise ship.
Una tuta solo.
Sure I'm going somewhere, Greedo. Put your gun up. I was on my way to see your boss. Tell Jabba the Hutt that I got his money.
Song pichale. Imaratamti dach makichita.
Anything you say, Greedo. Just don't get nervous with that thing. You don't mind if I put my feet up and relax, do you? It's been a long day. Yeah, Greedo, but this time I really got the money for
Java.
I haven't got it with me. I just picked up a job. Tell Heater and Jabba the Hutt that
Togurulje puljanja urwanzi pastika kushunkum podova tripi.
Look, even I get bored sometimes. I had to dump that load of spice. Do you think I had a choice?
Lapjaba, bupa, kumpakni at apampa.
Over my dead body.
Ches pokututa krista krenko.
Yeah, I'll bet. Rest in peace, Guido. I can shoot just as well under a table as a crossed one. Hey, bartender.
Yeah?
Here. That's for your trouble. Sorry about the mess.
Now you've done it, Solo. Heater's gonna want your neck for sure.
Yeah, you feel like standing in for him?
No, I didn't mean nothing.
Then get out of my way. I'm raising ship.
Sure.
Hey, and if you see Heater or Jabba the Hutt, tell him I'll be back in a day or two. I got a little quick money to make.
Two droids, a young farm boy, and a veteran Jedi Knight, caught up in a dangerous but vital mission, are now joined in their journey by a reckless pair of smugglers and soldiers of fortune. Against them, an empire moves with all the power at its command.